Welcome back. You know, one of the things about the rainy season and about the summer that many of us don't like is how fast grass grows. I mean, down in South Florida growing up, we cut the grass every 2 weeks, and we could have cut it every single week because it grew so quickly when it was warm and rainy. And I found that the grass grows even crazier down here in the true full-on tropics. But I'm not upset about it, because grass is a fantastic resource. Mulch, compost. I mean, you could feed it to your animals. You could stuff burlap with it and make a rough bed in your hobo shed. But no, really, I use grass for composting. And I'm not gonna sleep on a mattress of grass. That's kind of, I'm kind of allergic to grass, actually. So maybe it's therapeutic to cut it. So right now, anyhow, that's enough of that. I'm not gonna get too crazy. I had a little bit too much coffee. So let's go cut the grass and figure out how to make a YouTube video out of it and make it an important gardening point that you can take home. This is a teachable moment. Don't waste it, my friends.
What are you watching?
All right, check this out. Look, this is the path. This grass is taller than me at some points. This is the path leading down to where the other garden beds are, and the creek is. You can see where my children walk. They go swimming in the creek. But this is kind of insane. So it's time to bust out the string trimmer and harvest some valuable organic material. I'm cutting down grass like an Aminal, like an Aminal, like an Aminal. Oh, I'm cutting down grass like an Aminal, like an Aminal, like an Aminal. Oh, oh.
Up and down and here and there, I'm cutting grass like I just don't care. Don't have a scythe, but I cut with style. Put the grass in a nice big pile. Chop and drop and rake and take. Good gardeners, don't take a break. Soon my compost will be full. Cutting grass like an Aminal.
Cutting down grass like an Aminal.
That was a pretty good chunk of string trimming. It's a nice bit of grass we cut down there. A lot. And this is some thick stuff. I mean, it really resists the string trimmer, and it takes a lot of work to cut it. So I'd say I got maybe just over a third done, maybe a half done of the entire path. So that feels pretty good for now. I gotta rake some of this stuff up, and then we can use it. Why do I think grass is so great? I'm glad you asked. Grass is the green activator in compost piles. Like, if you start a pile and you cut your grass and you intersperse that with some leaves and brown material, shredded paper from the office or whatever else, you mix that in with some grass, the grass will kick off that compost. If you've ever let a pile of grass just sit raked up in the yard, I mean, it's turning white and hot inside within 24 hours and often within just a couple of hours. Two, grass is full of good stuff. In Korean natural farming and in the jadam method, they actually ferment grass in barrels as part of the fertilizer process they use. So grass itself, they have shown, is very good at picking up nutrients and then becoming available when you let it rot down. And so if you do your, you know, big swamp water barrels like I do, just throw a bunch of grass in there and let it rot and then use that as a fertilizer, and all the good stuff and all the work that the grass did pulling up minerals from the soil goes into your garden. Three, Grass is pretty good mulch. If you let it sit out for a day or so and dry out a bit, and then you go and put it as mulch, it lasts for a while, but it also breaks down and feeds the soil as it goes. My dad used to use grass as mulch all through the food forest and around the bits of landscaping that didn't have to look perfect. And I mean, grass does not look perfect as a mulch, but it rots quickly and it keeps the soil moist, so it acts as both a mulch and a fertilizer at the same time. So if you're regularly cutting grass, you can always throw another load of it down as mulch, and it will feed the soil at the same time. It keeps it cool. Finally, grass is good for your grazing animals. It's also good to throw in your chicken coop. It's good, you could dry it, and when you're raising little chicks, you know, just throw it. You don't have to go buy straw or hay or whatever else. If you've got grass on your property, you can let it grow a little longer, cut it yourself, use it for the animals, use it when you're raising chicks, use it in the hen house, use it in the nest boxes. It's nice stuff. You can use it in a mattress too. Did I mention that? Thanks for joining me as I get some much needed yard work out of the way. Hope you have a great weekend. And until next time, may your thumbs always be green.
I went to see David. David the good. We listened to Portishead and drank spiced rum.